She's able to just get a lot of tips and deflections, owning her length.
Hayes with the drop down to Williams. She is surrounded, tries to force it up, got it blocked. Bray, the all-star starter, skips to Ogwumike for three. And Nneka Ogwumike, who had 5 3-pointers in the game versus Washington last Sunday, is looking to get the lid off the rim. That makes the dream 2 of 8. Sparks 1 for 8 now. The tap followed by Ogwumike, no good, but she gets it back. One of the best offensive rebounders in the league. Williams dishes to Ogwumike. Airmails the baseline jumper. It's rebounded by Ruffin Pratt. Shot clock doesn't reset, and Williams lets it fly to beat the shot clock at 3 by Raquana Williams. Part of that national championship team at Baylor this past spring. A cinder block screen from Ogwumike that frees up Gray, who dishes down to Ogwumike. You can't run the pick and roll any better than that. Sparks begin possession in the second half. Nneka lowers her shoulder into Breland, just trucked her out of the way for 2.
George able to collect herself, but still got a little rushed with the rim.
And now it's Ogwumike converting on the other end, a 4-point swing for the Sparks. And now it's Kalani Brown taking, pumping, and laying it in. 6-7, she can run the floor, she can fill the lane too. Instead, it's swung to Pratt. Puts it on the deck in front of Montgomery. Rolls it off. Nneka Ogwumike, the rebound and the stick back. They lob it up to the rim. We'll see. Ruffin Pratt underneath to Ogwumike, who sheds Williams. But was it a shot clock violation? Did they get it off in time? Williams plays it to Ogwumike to hand off back to Raquana Williams, who knocks down another 3.
Even when you think you're contesting her, you've got to be one step up more than you think you are.
Gray the dump down, Ogwumike with the lay-in.